Well, last night, just after the announcement, opposition leader Judith Collins was quick to express her disappointment and point the finger of blame at the government for the new cases of community transmission in Auckland. Judith Collins joins us now to elaborate. Morena, Judith.
Oh, good morning, Scotty.
Judith, extremely disappointed is how you've responded to last night's news that we do have cases of COVID-19 in our community. When were you briefed and what did you discuss with the Prime Minister during that conversation?
Well, the Prime Minister rang me about 9:15 last night, just before her press conference, which was due to be on at 9:15 but was a little bit delayed. And she advised me that I was told that she wanted to speak to me on a national security issue. And that issue was that there was a family that had, where clearly COVID-19 had been discovered, and that family had no connection with overseas, so they believed it must be a community transmission. My concerns are, of course, is that COVID-19 is not something that's endemic in the community. We've been told we've had 102 days without any COVID-19 community transmission cases. So this must have come through a border or quarantine system in some way. I can't think of any other way that it's come in. The Prime Minister wasn't sure how it's come in, but I think what we're going to need to do is to find out exactly how it's been brought into the country, or certainly with this family. She also expressed some concern that some of the, particularly the father, had was at, you know, at a work situation. That was in another suburb from the home, and the children in yet another suburb for schooling. So there is a real, very real concern. She said she needed to move to level 3, and I think that's the right thing to do. But I do know that when we're looking at how this has happened, we're going to need to go back through those, see whether or not there's any contact at all, because it just can't have just manifested itself.
Well, no one is certain right now, are they, Ms. Collins? And that's the problem. No one knows the source of this. And you are saying that this must have come through a border or through one of our isolation facilities. Well, you can't possibly know that for sure.
Do you have any other ideas?
No,
well,
I don't.
Do you have any other ideas where it could come from?
No, exactly. What advice are you taking from your medical experts in this department?
Well, that it doesn't just manifest after 102 days of no community transmission. It's come from somewhere. And it's either that it's come through a border, or else it was lurking in a whole lot of people that weren't picked up in testing. There is obviously the most obvious choice would have to be that. So the Prime Minister said to me that she was taking this seriously, which I think she needs to. I think it's utterly devastating. I had 3 calls last night from small businesses. One of them in utter tears, looking at the loss of her business, having got through the level 4 lockdown, which almost destroyed the business, now looking at whether or not it's going to be completely finished this time. This is a very devastating time for people in business and their employees.
It certainly is.
The Prime Minister said that she would tell on us on Friday whether or not they traced it, whether or not we needed to go up to level 4 or whether or not, come back to level 2. But this is devastating.
I know that so many New Zealanders will be feeling the same way this morning, Ms. Collins. Do you believe that this is a systemic failure on the part of the Ministry of Health in their response to COVID-19?
Well, I hope not. And I hope it's something that is isolated to one person who somehow got this into, you know, infected a family. I don't know of that. And I think that's the point that the, Ms. Ardern said to me, is that they have no idea where it's come from. They don't know how it's got there. The fact that there is no idea where it's come from is even more concerning, because we're now hearing, about the testing. So I think there's a, we need calm, but let's be real here. There's a lot of people who are absolutely devastated. And the fact that they're looking at, waiting till Friday, waiting to see whether or not they've got a business, this is extremely serious for people. And if you've had your business put on hold for, about 7 weeks of lockdown, and you've suddenly, you know, you've used up all your savings to keep it going. This is really bad.
I'm sure that we will know more over the next 24 to 36 hours. We wish you a very safe day today. Leader of the National Party, Judith Collins, thank you for joining us.